Welcome to the June 2021 edition of the Columbus Square Dance News. Man, you can tell we're starting to open up out there. How do I know this? Well, because I'm starting to complain that dancing is cutting into my bicycling time. I'm going to have to clone myself to get everything done based on all the stuff that's on the calendar. But then again, who'd want two of me hanging around? So, hey, we got a lot to cover this month, so let me show off a few recent dances. Christy Williams and Elaine Windrow were rocking the house at the Pavilion in Dayton on April 24th. We had three squares on the floor most of the night. On April 25th, I was tickled to be invited out to a private dance north of Columbus. It was a terrific family-owned venue, and we were able to get three squares on the floor for a good chunk of the afternoon. Ed Pabst was calling, and Carol Pabst was queuing. Ed came back on May 1st to call for our Virus Be Damned dancers.
Split circulate and
on May 14th at the Pavilion, Dave Studdard and Linda Bishop were doing their thing with up to four squares on the floor.
Red hot, turn your right hand, lady by the right, go back to your partner.
On May 15th at Hicks and Chicks, there was some samba going on. Ed Loudenschlager was calling and Linda Warren was queuing. Also on May 15th, down in Nitro, West Virginia, Homer Magnet was getting three squares on the floor. On May 16th, John Ramsey came down from Cleveland to give Buckeye A2s a good show. Then John was back down on May 23rd to call for our Virus Be Damned group.
Everybody passed in. Double pass through.
For the Yellow Rockers, their first dance after the pandemic was at the Pavilion on May 9th with Jack Plattys and Elaine Windrow. Then Jack stopped by our Virus Be Damned dancers for a May 15th dance for a whole night of both advanced and plus dancing.
In the middle, star through. Same one.
Now, poor old Tom Davis, he's just going to have to move to Columbus. In addition to filling in for Jason Raleigh at the Buckeye A2 Wednesday workshops, he also called the first post-pandemic real Buckeye A2 Sunday dance on May 2nd, all here in Cowtown. Less than a week later, he was doing duty for our Virus Be Damned dancers. Now, the man may not know the difference between bears, goats, pigs, chickens, and sheep, except when they're on a pizza. He's quickly becoming the hardest working man in square dancing. I guess we're going to have to change his name to James Thomas Brown.
So good. So good. I got to hear. Oh, I feel nice.
Hey, upcoming events, boy, hang on to your hats, all right? Friday to Sunday of Memorial Day weekend, there's John Ramsey and Mexican refugee Jason Raleigh putting on the Baylor Beach Party. On Sunday, May 30th, Tom Davis and Wes Fenton are calling it Dancer's Day Out, but it's a remembrance dance for Wes Dyer. On every Tuesday night in June in Pickerington, Friendly Tides is having a free mainstream slash plus refresher course from 7 until 9. Gary Kincaid is teaching. Then starting Sunday, June 6th, Friendly Tides Club is having their first dance since the pandemic. It's all at the Pickerington Senior Center. Gary Kincaid and Chuck Berry, they're going to be putting on a show for us June 6th. Up in Cleveland, Mapletown Squares is starting their own refresher workshops on Tuesdays through June and July at the Munson Township Park. The Circulators do the same, but they're starting June 3rd, Thursday nights through August at the Ritchie Shelter House in Talmadge. Both courses are taught by John Ramsey. Also in Cleveland, The Hubs is starting a beginner class on Monday nights. First class is June 7th. Kenny Campbell is leading the class. Speaking of first dances since the pandemic headed its ugly rear, the Friday Night Mixers in Cleveland is having a special dance on Saturday afternoon, June 5th, from 2 until 4:30 p.m. Then the regular club starts back up dancing advanced on the second and fourth Friday starting June 11th. On Sundays in Beaver Creek, Whirlaways is back in business with an advanced workshop. Tom Davis will usually be there, but you never know when Jack Plattys or Jason Raleigh or Ken Stomps might be taking over. It's from 7 to 9 p.m. at the Hawker Church in Beaver Creek. On Saturday, June 19th in Seymour, Indiana, there's a trail through dance for the National Convention. It's sponsored by the Dynamic Dancers and Star Promenaders. It'll feature Scott and Sean Brown and Lisa Minton. Hey, speaking of, from Wednesday through Sunday, June 23rd through 26th, well, it's the Nationals. Going to be held in Jackson, Mississippi. I've publicly predicted on more than one occasion that I didn't think this dance was going to be a go, but here we are. The number of attendees is, at the time of this video, less than 2,000. Unless there's a tsunami of registrations in the next 4 weeks, it will be the least attended Nationals ever. That record was previously set just in 2018 at the Kansas City Nationals with only 3,169 dancers. Folks, we're going the wrong direction on this, all right? Anyway, if you've never been to a national convention, I encourage you to go. It's always a good show. It's always amazing to see the diversity in dancers from literally all over the world. Now, I'll be down there taking pictures and videos to share. If you can't make it, I'll do my best to get things uploaded in a timely manner. Check the calendar links and website flyer tables for all the details. On our Sunshine page, Columbus dancer Debbie Kitts has undergone 2 surgical procedures, and she's starting radiation treatment for breast cancer. Cura Linda Bishop broke her foot. Now, at the time of this video, I honestly can't remember if she recently had surgery or she's going in to have it done shortly. So, in either case, keep them both in your prayers. In our one last big circle segment, caller Ken Roberts passed away in May. All right, this is Math 101, y'all. We have a problem. This is the 3rd monthly news video in a row where I've had to report that we've lost a caller due to retirement or passing away. I know of a couple of other callers who had to hang it up because there was no work during the pandemic. They had to go get a job. Now, I can only speak of Ohio area callers, but if you set aside those callers who are age 75 or older in this area, boy, the caller cupboard is getting a little bare, boys and girls. In this general area, the last caller school, which I'm aware of, finished up right before the pandemic took over the world. Those graduates had little to no opportunity to get out and practice their newly acquired talents. In other words, we don't have a lot of new callers in the pipeline, y'all. So, we have a shortage of callers. Now, basic laws of supply and demand say that when you have a shortage of a good or service, prices go up. Except we have another problem. Club membership is way down. The pandemic not only thinned out our ranks, but prevented us from bringing in new dancers. Clubs are folding, and they're consolidating, and they're cutting back on their dance schedules. Anymore, when I hear a club has somehow managed to put more than 4 squares on the floor for a regular dance, well, that's remarkable news. Clubs are facing rising cost in hiring callers, while at the same time, they're having less revenue to pay those higher costs. Now, callers need to be compensated for their time. If the caller is having to drive 3 hours to a 3-hour dance and then drive 3 more hours back home, well, that's 9 to 10 hours of their time. It's only right they're paid for that. Even if you think $25 to $30 an hour is a fair wage to pay a caller, that happens to be what I think, 10 hours of time is $250 to $300. Now, most clubs can't afford that for a single dance. Now, we got one more problem to throw on the heap. With a shortage of callers, dancers aren't going to get a lot of variety. I mean, filet mignon is good, but I'm not sure I want it 5 nights a week. I personally like dancing to different callers. What are we going to do about all this? Well, one suggestion is technology, y'all. Virtual dances. Callers can be at one location while the actual dance is at another. And this will solve all of the problems on this list. Instead of having to invest 9 to 10 hours of travel time, wear and tear in the car, and food, a caller only has to be on for the 3 hours of the dance. Throw in 30 minutes prior to ensure the technology is working. Then the caller doesn't have to charge as much. $30 an hour, now you're talking around $100 for a dance. Plus, clubs can hire from anywhere. You want to get Tim Teal from down in Texas? Well, how about Andy Alameo from San Diego? Now those callers are within your budget constraints. Hey callers, you want to bump that $100 per dance amount up? Well, with a virtual dance, you can truly be in 2 places at once. Callers in Cincinnati. The dancers, though, they're in Tampa and Indianapolis. It's incredibly easy to pull off. The caller charges each club $100. You know, put 2 or 3 clubs out there and you're going to make a couple of bucks. Now, clubs are going to have to acquire some robust computers and internet connections, and they're also going to have to get some professional-grade sound equipment. You're probably going to need somebody geeky to help put it all together, but truly, this is not difficult stuff, and it's not expensive to put together. But what it is basic math, all right? And we should all start thinking along those lines. In our general stuff session, well, you know, last month I mentioned Kitty Hawks was dropping their square dance program in favor of all rounds. I had it in my head that it was a temporary move, but I hear that it's permanent. So Kitty Hawks will just be a round dance club from this point forward. In Columbus, it's a done deal merging orbiting squares and bucks and does, and from what I hear, they're going to be known as bucks and does and orbiting squares, which is just a ridiculously long name. But that's the deal. And the combined club is going to be dancing first and fourth Fridays. Now, personally, me, if I was a square dancing czar, I'd combine all the clubs. I'd pick a couple of locations around the city, one on the north side of the city, one on the south side. Then on the first and third weekends, a north dance on the Fridays, the south dances on the Saturdays, and you switch them for the second and fourth. South dances on Friday, north dances on Saturday. That covers the folks who are going to bitch that they have to drive too far to get to the dance. And you cover every weekend. And you don't have clubs competing for dancers. And you do away with all the overhead of having multiple clubs. Hell, merging just to simplify the annual insurance coverage nightmare ought to be enough incentive to do this. Yes. Hey, Colleen and Marky Gurman celebrated their 31st anniversary in May. Colleen, were you like, 12 when you got married? Congratulations, y'all. Hey, Katie Raleigh was finally able to scrape enough ransom payment for Jason. I know the word on the street that he was working in Mexico, but the truth of the matter is this picture shows that he was being held by a couple of desperados. Well, he's finally been released and he flew back to Los Estados Unidos as of just a few days ago. Jason, I know Katie and the boys are glad to have you back, and I got to tell you, we dancers are too. Congratulations to Miami Valley for their new website. Karen Townley was able to pull it together. That's a good thing. That last webmaster y'all had, he was a sketchy dude, let me tell you. Hey, wrapping it up, a big thank you to Tom Davis and Kathy Newman for bringing class and sex appeal to last month's video news. But now that I think about it, I'm not sure what Tom brought, because it was Kathy that had all the class and sex appeal. He brought his phone, I guess. Hey, Kathy got a lot of comments about how good she was on camera, and she was, no doubt. She responded to each compliment, well, Ray wrote the script, I just read it. Well, that's not completely true. She wasn't immune to ad-libbing.
If you don't give Ray something to say, he'll just make stuff up and start telling really old jokes and tell you about his time in the Navy and all of his women. And trust me on this, unless you're looking to cure insomnia, you don't want that to happen.
Then again, let me tell you about this one little blonde I met while I was stationed in Virginia Beach. Oh boy, yeah, that was something else. Let me tell you, oh boy. Anyway, hey, as always, you can check links below this video for more information about stuff I talked about. Well, okay, except for maybe that little blonde in Virginia Beach. If you've got news about your dancers, your club, your events, I'd like to pass that word along. Send me an email. Let me know the details. And we're going to scoot out of here with a little bit of Ken Roberts calling for a little brown jug. Y'all be safe and well, and I'll see you here next month.
Same hand, square through down four. Find your corner, reach out two hands, single circle, rear back, star through, roll the pacer, do it all again, single circle, rear back, star through, roll, swing and parade! A one and three, you promenade, go halfway around the bridge. Do the right and left side. Same head, square, do count four. Find the corner, reach out two hands, single circle. Rear back, start through, roll, do it all again. Swing, promenade, I can hold it, you're really going to